Hey everyone, welcome back to another video by AppSecEngineer. So this is actually one of our lab videos in the Secrets in AWS course on AppSecEngineer.com. My colleague Abhay is going to showcase the implementation and use cases of Key Management Service in AWS using the Python Jupyter Notebook and the Boto3 library. So Abhay is going to start off with the basics of customer managed keys in KMS and then talk about the difference between symmetric and asymmetric keys. So once that is done, Abhay is going to then talk about the importance of a concept called envelope encryption. The envelope key, also known as the data key, is used to both encrypt and decrypt data, whereas the CMK or the customer managed key is going to be used as a wrapper key to wrap the data key. Finally, Abhay is going to look at a use case and walk you through the entire implementation of envelope encryption using KMS. Let's get started. If this is the sort of content you'd like and enjoy, please consider subscribing to this YouTube channel and also like the video. We're also active on LinkedIn and Twitter, where we're going to be constantly posting updates around Kubernetes security, cloud security, AppSec, DevSecOps, and a whole lot more.
Now, the way this works is that you have text segments and you have code segments. Now, when you get on the code segments, you will see this green border appear. You know, it highlights that code segment. So this is a code segment. When you want to run this code, what you need to do is make sure that it's green bordered, it's highlighted in green, and then click on run. When you click on run, it runs that piece of code. So it says, it gives you the date. So the thing is, we're clicking on the code. So the next thing we're doing now is we're going to generate a symmetric key. So what we're doing is, let's look at the code here. In this case, we're going to generate a symmetric CMK, customer master key. So in the symmetric CMK, what we're doing is we're generating a symmetric CMK. We're using this to encrypt and decrypt data. This is a symmetric. You can use multiple types of defaults, but we're just using the default, which is AES 256 GCM. And we are also tagging this key. So whenever we're using this key, we're also tagging this key. Once this key is created in our KMS, this should come back with a key ID, Amazon resource name, key ID for that. And it just assigns a variable to that key ID. So it generates a symmetric key. All right. Now let's look at a concept called envelope encryption. So let me explain this concept with a diagram. Now, in any cloud provider, one of the things that they do is that the key that they give, the master key itself, right? The master key should not be used to directly encrypt data. Okay. Don't directly encrypt or decrypt data with the master key. You can do it. I'm not saying you can't. But one of the things you should keep in mind is by doing that, what happens is it only has a limit on what is the data size it can encrypt and decrypt. So what you should do when you want to actually encrypt data. So let's say you have a credit card number or a big file that you want to encrypt. So what you should do is from the CMK, you can generate a secondary key. So you can generate two versions of that. You can generate the plaintext version of that key. Let's call that the data key. And you can also generate the encrypted version of that data key. So when you want to encrypt data, what you do is you generate the data key, you encrypt whatever data you want to encrypt, and you can only store the encrypted version of that data key in your database. So you can store it in your database. So you have the CMK that generates a data key, and the data key is used to encrypt. The plain text version of this is used to encrypt data, and the encrypted version of that data key is stored in your database. You can store it in your database without any difficulty. Now, let's say you want to decrypt that data. So let's say that there's a big image file you want to decrypt. Now, what happens then is that you have the CMK first decrypt the data key, then use that plain text version of that data key to decrypt the actual data. So it's a two-step process. When you are encrypting, you generate the encryption data key and you encrypt the data. When you're decrypting, you first decrypt the data key, then use the decrypted data key to decrypt your data. I know it's a lot of back and forth happening, but the idea here is that you don't directly use the CMK to do encryption and decryption of data. So CMK, think of it as a key encrypting key and not a data encrypting. So you should, so let's say you have an application. So let's say I have an application that is a Acme employee directory application, and I want to encrypt employee names, or let us say I want to encrypt employee social security numbers. Now, I'm not going to directly use the CMK to encrypt. So what I'm going to do is when I initialize my application, I generate from the CMK, I generate two keys. One is the plaintext data key and the encrypted data key. I store the encrypted data key in my database and I use the plaintext data key to encrypt. So what happens? So let's say a user logs in with their social security number. What I do is I have my CMK first decrypt the data key, then using the decrypted version of the data key, I decrypt the actual data. That's what's happening. That is what envelope encryption is all about. So the idea here is that you have a CMK, that is the customer master key. You don't directly encrypt and decrypt data with the customer master. So you first generate a plain text data key, and with that data key, you actually encrypt and decrypt the actual data, and not directly with the CMK, okay? With the customer master key. You don't directly encrypt and decrypt data. You generate an intermediate key, which is called the data key, to encrypt and decrypt the actual data set. That's what envelope encryption is. Now here, what we're going to do is we're going to generate a data key. So remember, in the previous step, we generated a CMK. Now we're going to use that CMK to generate a data key. Now this data key is going to give you two types of responses. It's going to give you a plain text version. It's going to give you a ciphertext version. Obviously, do not store the plain text version. This is a key. Just like any encryption key, this is also a key. You can store the ciphertext version in your database or wherever you want to store it. So let's run this. Click run, and it's going to generate a. So it generates a data key with the plain text version. In this case, of course, I'm showing the plain text version, but remember, please do not store this anywhere. This should not be stored. You should only be storing the ciphertext blob that comes back from that. So this generates that intermediate key. So remember, the CMK generates the intermediary key, which is the data key. Now this is what you use to actually encrypt data. You can use this key to encrypt data. So let's do that. Let's go to info and install a small library that we need. Click run, and it should say requirement already satisfied. Great. So this is a small Python crypto library that we're using. We're just installing it on the fly. Basically, that's what we do. Let's go to info and see what's happening here. Now we are actually encrypting some data. Now remember, we are not encrypting data with the CMK. We generated that data key. And with that data key, we are going to encrypt the actual data. So the data we want to encrypt is, hello, this is some plain text data. Okay. We are going to use AES CFB mode. So we are using the plain text version. You remember the plain text that we saw here? We are using the plain text version of that key. And we are going to encrypt this data set. When we do that, you will see that we have generated a ciphertext for this string. So the next thing we're going to do is we're going to decrypt the same data set. You will see that once we click on in6 and click on run, it will decrypt and come back with the plain text. Right, so that's basically the encryption and decryption. Remember, we are not encrypting and decrypting with the CMK. We are only encrypting and decrypting with the data key. When you're encrypting data, it's data key. When you're encrypting the key, it's CMK, or decrypting the key itself. Okay, so that's something that you should keep in mind. Now, the next thing we're going to do is rotate the CMK that we generated. So we generated a CMK. We are going to rotate it. So this is what this is going to do is enable key rotation, and it rotates that CMK. Okay. So what this does, it rotates that CMK, and we have enabled rotation on our CMK, which is the key ID this. Now the next thing we're going to do is generate an asymmetric CMK. So far we looked at symmetric CMK. Now let's look at the asymmetric CMK. Right, so in here we're going to generate a new CMK. Now remember, unless it's RSA, I cannot use asymmetric to do anything but sign and verify. Remember signature and verification. So I sign some data and I want to verify if the data is integrity is valid, then I use asymmetric, right? So I'm only using this asymmetric key for signature and verification. So it generates an asymmetric key and it does not, it just, you know, gives you, it generates that asymmetric key. That's essentially what's happening here. So this is an asymmetric key that is generated when you run. So this generates a CMK. Now, just like you can do with the symmetric key, you can also generate, you can generate intermediate keys, but I'm not going to do that. I'm just going to generate the public key first. And then I'm going to, so far what you're doing when you're generating this, you generate the private key first, right? Remember, the private key is stored in AWS. This key ID, all of the private keys are stored in AWS. So this is the customer managed key. If I refresh the page, the private key is stored in AWS, right? But the public key, like as I mentioned, is public, so you can get access to it. So when I say get public key, when you do intent, you will see that you actually get the public key as a byte array. So you see the public key as a byte array here, it gives you the public key, okay? So remember, anything signed with the private key can only be verified by the public key, okay? So this is signature, we're talking about signature. So what we're going to do is we're going to generate some JSON. The JSON is going to be hello world, and we are going to sign it with our private key, and we are going to verify it with our public key. Okay, that's what's happening here. Intent. Anyway, so what we're doing is we are using the asymmetric key that we generated. We are using the key ID, and we are generating a signature. So what we're doing here is we are generating a JSON called hello world. And we are going to sign that hello world, that JSON value. Okay. So let's run this. And we have the signature. You can see the signature, which is a byte array. This, we can base64 it for better representation. But the idea here is that you are, you know, I'm just showing you the raw byte indication here. And let's say you want to verify. So somebody sends you a message called hello world. You want to make sure that this has not been tampered with in transit. So, and they also send you the signature. So the signature is affixed to the message. You get the signature and you obviously have their public key. You verify against that signature and let's see, it gives you a, hey, I have verified the signature successfully. This message has not been tampered with in transit. That's basically how a sign and verify works.
If you found this video useful, please consider subscribing to the channel and like the video. And don't forget to follow us on LinkedIn and Twitter for this sort of content and updates. If you're looking to learn more about cloud native security, Kubernetes security, DevSecOps, AppSec automation, threat modeling, and a whole lot more, go get a subscription for amazing courses and a ton of hands-on labs on AppSecEngineer.com.